watching Southwest Florida's morning news source. This is Fox 4 Rising.
Good morning. Welcome back. It's about 6:30. I bet a lot of you are up early because you have to get out the door and go get your last-minute shopping done. So, Jamie, come on, give them the forecast.
I think it's either going to be the frantic get out the door, or it's going to be, you know what, I'm sleeping a little bit today. It's going to be one or the other. It's chilly out there. We're in mid-40s, not like yesterday, low 60s. So, yeah, the roller coaster ride that we're on, we're on it for a while, folks. When you see the 7-day forecast, we're going to be reaching the top. The peak is coming up over the next day or so, and then another deep drop in that roller coaster ride. 44, sunny, chilly, 64 noon, and 66 at 5 o'clock. Lots of sunshine out there. There'll be a little bit of cloud cover drifting across the area. That'd really be about it. 40s right now, 50s on the islands, 43 Port Charlotte, Cape Coral 47, Naples at 47, and Clewiston. We're sitting at 44 right now. Your forecast looks like this. Looks much like yesterday. A lot of sunshine. That's a little on the cool side. Light winds and right around 70 degrees. It's okay. And we're talking partly cloudy. A little bit of cloud cover. No threat for rain tonight, but chilly again. 40s and some low 50s. That is standby. 1-4 weather forecast.
Thanks, Jamie. Oh, what? Okay, we are just getting word that Santa has, in fact, left the North Pole this morning for his very busy day of toy delivering. He's in the Pacific Ocean area right now near Asia, but the big question is, when is he going to get here to Southwest Florida? This morning, we are joined by Major Mike Humhpreys, commander of North American Aerospace Defense Command and U.S. Northern Command. He's been tracking Santa's progress all morning with some pretty cool technology. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Yeah, and good morning and Merry Christmas. And I would like to correct, I'm not the commander, but I do support the commander and NORAD.
Okay, fabulous. That's all right. Well, thanks for that correction. And tell me a little bit about where Santa is right now and when the kids watching can expect him to be here in Southwest Florida.
Well, you know, he is, as you mentioned, he is over Asia right now, Eastern Asia, and he is speeding along, going from the, you know, far east, moving his way towards the west. He left probably about half an hour ago from the North Pole to start his trip around the world. And when he's actually going to be in Florida, it's hard to say. You know, he kind of varies his route up a little bit each year, but he should enter into North America sometime around midnight Eastern time. Or about midnight Atlantic time, actually, probably, when he enters into North American airspace.
But for all the little kids watching, that doesn't mean you can stay up till midnight, because there's a good chance he might show up early. He's very punctual. So how do you guys track him? You have some pretty sophisticated technology?
That's correct. We have, North American Aerospace Defense Command, it's a binational command between Canada and the United States, and normally, our mission, 365 days a year, is to provide aerospace warning, aerospace control, and maritime warning for all of North America. And it lends itself very well to be able to track Santa Claus this time of year. We have satellites in the sky that are able to pick up specific signatures, which Rudolph's nose shows up very well on those satellite images. We have 47 radars scattered throughout North America that are able to pick up Santa Claus once he enters into North American airspace. And every year this time of year, we use Santa cams, too, located in very specific geographical locations around the world that are very familiar to most people, so that when he passes those geographical landmarks, people are able to go on to Google Earth, where all of our information is being fed, and they can see exactly where Santa is in the world and kind of get an idea about when he's going to be by their home.
Okay, and just one quick last question. I know some people have been watching, and the weather's been kind of crazy across the U.S. A couple kids out there asked me, they were worried, is Santa going to be able to make it to my home because of all of that nasty weather? But I think Rudolph's nose will help guide him, right?
I tell you, we've been doing this for more than 55 years, and of course, Santa's been doing it for a lot longer than that. And I can tell you that the weather never seems to bother Santa Claus. He's got his magic, his abilities are much greater than our own sophisticated technologies, and he's able to do this every year, and nothing seems to get in the way of his mission every year to do this.
All right, U.S. Army Major Mike Humphreys, thank you so much for what you guys do, and good luck tracking Santa this morning.
Thank you very much, and Merry Christmas to you.